Hello everyone, welcome to our channel. We are going to solve this GATE 2013 question of manufacturing technology. First question is, for a good quality of brazing, the molten filler alloy should have. Okay, so what is the requirement for a molten filler alloy to have a good brazing? So guys, we know in the case of brazing, suppose these are the two pieces and there is a gap through which, by the mechanism of this capillary action, the liquid metal goes, right? So this, to happen this capillary action, we required low contact angle, because once we have low contact angle, that means it has better wettability, right? So once it has better wettability, so it will be able to penetrate through their wettability, then it will be able to penetrate this one, right? So answer will be A. Next, risers are not required for casting. So for which case riser is not required? Riser will be not required where the shrinkage is very less, right? So we know that in the case of gray cast iron, actually the shrinkage is, you can say it is positive. That means it does not shrink, rather it expands because of the formation of graphite, right? So what happens during this casting? The graphite form, the free form of graphite has got larger volume, so that's why it increases the volume of that. So the correct answer will be gray cast iron. Okay, next, arc welding is done using current voltage and welding speed of 200 ampere, 20 volt and 0.01 meters per second respectively. The heat input in kilojoule per unit length is, okay guys, so this is a problem related to heat input in welding, right? So this heat input is, we can write it as this V into I. So V into I gives you the power, right? That means the joule per second, that is the power is flowing, and it is flowing with a certain, it is flowing through a welding process which is happening with some velocity, that is 0.01, right? So once it is happening with 0.01, so we will divide this, like, so 0.01, that means it is your velocity, right? And if it has got some efficiency, then we will multiply the efficiency over here. Since it is not given any efficiency, then we will consider this one as 100%, right? So VI, it is 200 into 20 by 0.01, so it will be 4000 into 10 power 2, right? So it is given in kilojoule per unit length, so in kilojoule it will be 400 kilojoule per meter, right everyone? So this is the answer. Next, a 480 mm thick slab is hot rolled using a roll of 720 mm diameter. Okay, for a coefficient of friction of 0.5, the maximum possible reduction in mm is, okay? So guys, this is a rolling process and here lot of questions are asked regarding this. So now you see, this is the plate which is being rolled. So this delta H value, which is the reduction, is your it is nothing but mu square into R. That gives you the maximum reduction, right? So you can write it as delta H max. So here mu, it is given, how much is mu? 0.5, so 0.5 square into radius. Guys, here it is given diameter, so we will convert this into radius. So 720 by 2, so it will be 0.5, if it will be 0.25 into 360, right? So you can write as 4 4, so it will be 9 0, right? So it will be 90 mm. So this 90 mm will be the maximum reduction which we can achieve, right, through this coefficient of friction and these rolls, right? So will be this. Next, match the defects listed in group 1 with the corresponding manufacturing process listed in group 2. Okay, the first one is orange peel effect, then several cracking, then flash, then undercut. So orange peel effect, it is observed during the deep drying process, right? So what is happening during a deep drying process? Suppose this is a curve, so at the surface it should be the flat, right? But in the case of where this orange peel kind of thing occurs, so basically what happens, in some because of this differences in the plastic deformation in different direction, so it is something like this. So this part is called earing, but what happens because of this expansion in one direction more, some less expansion in other direction, what happens, this orange peel kind of a thing happened. That means it forms a surface where you will see a, like a orange peel, if you see that contains small dot like that is over there, right? So that is because of this difference in this plastic deformation which we observe in different direction. Okay, so orange peel effect will match with this deep drawing. Then Severn cracking. So Severn cracking happens during this extrusion process. So what happens during extrusion? Suppose this is the die extruding this one. So what happens in the middle, right? Because middle is the portion which is least resistant to motion, and this is the surface which is highly resistant, right? So due to this difference in this plastic deformation, also some cracks can generate at the center. So this center location is prone to this Severn cracking. So it happens during extrusion. Next is the flash. Flash is formed during forging. So what is that? Suppose you do some kind of die forging, then suppose this, so there is some extra gap which is there, so from there this metal can flow, right? And because of that, this is called as nothing but a flash, right? So this thing happened in the case. Next is the undercut happens during this arc welding. So in the case of arc welding, like suppose this is the piece you are welding, right? Now you have welded this portion, but you have welded this portion, but this portion, you know, there is a small area which is left, right? So this is happened during this arc welding process. So once it is left over there, so this can be called as undercut, right? So this is the thing which happened. So it is like this. Let us move. Match the powder production techniques given in group 1 with the corresponding shape listed in group 2. See, the first one is the reduction. Reduction, that means like first one is the reduction. So reduction happens like suppose there is a oxide kind of particles, then we remove the oxygen. So once we remove the gaseous compound, that is oxygen, then it creates some pores in that. So due to this formation of pores, so it forms a very spongy like structure. Okay, the next is your gas atomization. The gas atomization leads to a spherical one, because gas atomization, the cooling rate is sufficient so that this liquid metal allows to cool in a such manner that there is a uniform cooling which takes place throughout the surface. So you get this spherical one. Next is the milling. So in the case of milling, we get flaky one. We know that because of milling process, the surface breaks and new surfaces are formed. So these are flaky in nature. And next is electrolysis. In the case of electrolysis, we get dendritic one. Because electrolytic, what happens? Deposition of layer by layer things happen. So when the deposition takes place, so it grows in a dendritic manner. Right? Okay. Match the suitability of non-destructive testing method in group 1. Oh, it is raining over here. So you can hear the sound of rain. Match the suitability of non-destructive testing method in group 1 for the detection of defects listed in group 2. First one is your magnetic particle inspection. So magnetic particle inspection, you know, it is done for surface examination, right? And it is done for magnetic material. So here you see surface crack in Martensitic, surface crack in Austenitic. So which is magnetic? it is your Martin sitting, right? So one will match with one, P will match with one. Q, X-ray and radiography. X-ray radiography means radiography we do for the internal one, right? So what is the defect which will be internal? Like it will be inclusion in solid. So that is the internal one. Because these inclusions have got different density, so it can be easily identified in using this radiography technique. Next is the diapenetrant. Diapenetrant we do for surface defect, right? So these surface defects we can determine. Like we can do it for surface crack in austenitic stainless steel also, and here it is shown like hairline crack in aluminium. Now see hairline crack. So where this hairline crack occurs? So this hairline crack occur inside of that material, right? So this can be done using this ultrasonic testing. So this ultrasonic testing will be used for this hairline crack in aluminium. And this diapenetrant will be used for just the surface crack, right? So P matches with 1, Q matches with 4, R matches with 2, right? S matches with 3. So option D. Okay guys, so these were some of the questions which I have discussed. I hope it was beneficial for you. So thank you all.